Day. It is Primary Artemis Shadow Studios 9, the koala in the suit, here, and something different. This is technically the Tinkerbox, but whoopsies, it is a different part of the Tinkerbox than we are normally in. Today, we are in the Nether. And you probably just saw the time lapse, and as you can see, I picked up another one, so that's the one I just picked up. For that time lapse was 10 minutes worth of this farm, and so in 10 minutes I got 15 gold nuggets and 15 rotten flesh. And so, what this is a redstoneless zombie pigman farm. I know I've seen some good zombie pigman farms, but usually they either take some like complicated timers or they take like a stack of pistons, which, by the way, is freaking expensive for people in survival mode. So I thought I would make the cheapest possible pig farm. And a pig farm that is cheap involves absolutely no redstone on any level whatsoever. So, what I've done here is just created something where the pigmen will end up walking down and killing themselves. It's pretty simple, and first off, before we go over how to build it, I'll go over the stats with you. Okay. So, in what I like to call realistic mode, which means that someone has just kind of, you know, haphazardly covered the surrounding area or destroyed it so pigmen wouldn't spawn on it. On realistic mode, and with two tiers of this farm, you get one per minute pigman wise, and that's with two layers, so you know, that's not too bad, that's not too much work, and of course it's really easy to add more layers and really fastly increase that. Now at optimized mode, which means most of the area around it is covered up, so zombie pigmen can mostly only spawn on the farm, you get about 5 per minute on 2 layers. So I think for a redstoneless farm, that's not terribly bad, especially for only 2 layers, which isn't much. Okay, now how to build this is, first you find yourself a decent place to build it. I recommend a lava lake, something like that. And you start with a 21 by 21 square of half slabs. The half slabs are to ensure that things don't start spawning down here. And then, why am I not climbing? Oh, that's right, I'm in flying mode. Okay. And then, when you come up here and you start building your layers, these layers, the blocks themselves, not including these outside fence gates, is 17 by 17. Now the reason it's so much smaller than down below is so that when the zombie pigmen go walking off, they still fall on this edge, and they don't walk off into the lava and you lose your drops and all that badness. So, you make a 17 by 17 layer here, and then you cut out a three wide section to the center on all these sides here, and even though these are fence gates, I recommend you fill it with glass panes, like so. Like I did up here, you can see it's glass panes instead of fence gates. And then you cut out the four in the approximate center of these things, since they're not exactly square, they don't have a perfect center, but you cut out a 4x4 hole in the center and put glass panes in it. And the reason I recommend using the glass panes instead of the fence gates, even though glass panes are slightly less effective than fence gates, when you're doing one of these farms, you will start getting some magma cubes, and if you use the fence gates instead of the glass panes, then a magma cube can fall through the fence gates, a magma cube that is a large size, and when the large one falls down and you're AFKing down here, it's just going to kill you. Whereas with these glass panes, the only magma cubes that can fall through are the smallest size, and those ones can't hurt you. I think there's one or two of them in the time lapse. But yeah, and then with the fence panes, you have a 2-wide layer all the way along the outside. And it's basically the same design in the 17 by 17 cube. Now that 17 by 17 doesn't include these outsides. And you want 3 spaces, so that's space enough for you to jump between each layer, just because I found that they for some reason spawned more pigmen when they had 3 instead of 2. Not exactly sure why that is. But yeah, so it's pretty simple. The only expensive part of this would be the glass panes, because the platforms themselves can be made out of whatever material you have. Now you do have to be really careful walking around up here, because you can easily fall through the glass panes like the zombie pigmen can. And the nice thing about this farm is, aside from the fact that it's cheap to build, because aside from the glass panes, you can just use whatever cheap resources you have, you can also use it as an aggro farm. Now, I wanted to build a farm where you wouldn't have to aggro the zombie pigmen, because aggroing the zombie pigmen can be dangerous for your health. I don't have any pigmen on the top layer at the moment, because we've been flying around up here. But if you wanted to, you could use this as an aggro farm as well, so you've been AFKing for a while and you see there's still a bunch of pigmen up here, you can just shoot one and then they'll all try to run to you and fall through the glass panes and fall to their imminent doom. So I thought it was pretty neat, and I like it because it's cheap, it doesn't involve redstone. However, just because you can do it without redstone, I would recommend, if you know enough about redstone and have enough resources, that you do make it with redstone, because a redstone farm is, you know, probably about twice as efficient as this farm is. But this farm is good and cheap for someone just starting out who wants to gather some good gold nuggets and farm some gold from the pigmen. So, this has been Primary Artemis, Shadow Studios 9, and I'm here saying, toodles!